provincial election, and it is very important to be clear about why we are here. Who caused this to happen? The current Liberal government changed the funding formula for child welfare. They not only changed it, they lowered the amount available, and then they said you gotta live within your means. But the work that you do is mandated work. It's about crisis. You can't plan for crisis. You have to deal with crisis. That's what we've done for generations in Ontario. That's what we need to do in the future. We need money to plan and to fund the work we do. Dave Levesque, the representative for this community, he has a responsibility to the people of Brant County to answer for that decision.
The 5 shutdown days is not only impacting workers, their pay, their pensions, their days of service. We are taking service directly away from our families and clients, and that's just not acceptable. We need to send a strong message, especially right now when we have the power to vote and vote in a government that believes in social services.
The first official day that the agency is closing is June 30th and will be closed for 4 days in a row. Did you guys ask the youth and the families their input? What are the cutbacks are you guys going to be making? Because this cutback closing down the agency for 5 days a year is not right. There's other things that you guys can do to save money. This is not one of them. The agency has done a lot for the youth and the families in our community, but this is not going to help things. It'll make it worse.
Today, we need to stand up for the vulnerable. Thank you very much for ensuring the good work that we do to keep children safe in Ontario happens today and every day. We're not going to tolerate it. Our children need our help. We are here and we are their proud, proud voice.
Many of us came to Children Aid Society to fight and to support and to advocate for the families, children, and youth that we work with and service. But here's my question. Who advocates for us? Who advocates for the funding? Who advocates for the service? Well, I'll tell you, we rely on our management staff, your board of directors. And so my question to them, and I hope they're listening, is where is the advocacy that they're offering? Where are they standing up to the government? Where are they standing up to their own budgets to say, no, we need to provide the service. We need to not lay off people. We need to continue this. We need to keep programs open. Where is that happening? And that's the biggest change.